So there's a couple things that are important about this book. One, I just want to introduce kind of where it came from, and it started with a number of conversations that we were having sort of independently, and then realized the three of us were actually having the same conversation, which the field itself of what we're calling geographies of aging or geographical gerontology was gaining a lot of momentum, and people were talking about it, people were publishing research in the area, but there wasn't anything that anyone could point to that actually explained what it was, other than some leading papers, for example, that Gavin had led in the earlier of the 2000s. And so that really led to the genesis of thinking about creating a book that would allow us to work through what geographical gerontology was as a field of study, and really what it is different perspectives and applications of geographical perspectives on aging. And so scale, global, national, regional, local, and so on, through to issues of place in terms of people's connection to their communities and so on, and issues of space in terms of relationships. And these are things that have been around a long time in geography and used by different people within gerontology, but hadn't actually been brought together in one sort of leading sort of volume. And so that was unashamedly the purpose of this book, was something that we could point to and say, this will provide you some definitional information in the field. And what it led to was actually pulling together a team of 32 leading scholars or people who were just at different career stages in terms of entering the field of looking at geographies of aging, and inviting them to contribute different chapters, both on the concepts that geographers use, from cultural geography and health geography and so on, through to different scales in which aging occurs, and so there's chapters on aging at the global level, urban aging and rural aging and so on, through to the key issues, so things like place attachment and aging in place. These scholars, to our great delight, happen to be people that we refer to in our own work as leaders in the field. So in each of our cases, the people who supervised our own PhDs, in terms of Graham Rolls, David Phillips, and Mark Rosenberg, were people we were able to invite and agree to participate in this book. And I think that's something that speaks to the longevity and interest in the field, and something, especially as a more junior colleague, is an amazing experience to go through in terms of having people support us in this regard. So there's many more people involved in the book, in which we obviously encourage you to look through. And the more important thing, I suppose, is that it really comes out of an interest in creating something that would be useful across different aspects of career stages. So something that the three of us are interested in using in our own work as faculty members, but also something that's written in a way that's actually compelling for graduate students in terms of, you know, setting up new masters and PhD projects. And I think that's an ambition that's actually quite useful for us to undertake. So I'm going to stop at that point.
Okay. So it's, as I've long said, it's like if there are books that show different empirical realities of aging in rural areas, well, what about the concepts and approaches? We needed master students, PhD students in particular, to be able, who are entering the field, to be able to get insight into these concepts and approaches in one place, and that's what the book provides. We're also trying to bring together different perspectives, there's different paradigms in any research field. So there's obviously, just taking notes earlier, the kinds of theoretical perspectives and lenses we have in the book. So we have spatial science, good old-fashioned mapping, geography that maps at the distributive features of aging populations and services. There's a political economy perspective in certain chapters that looks at how resources and policies for older people work out spatially over scales ranging from local to global. We've got humanistic perspectives in there. Qualitative perspectives considers the sense of place in relation to the places that older people frequent. We've got social constructivism as a theoretical approach, which considers how places of aging are invented, positioned, and imagined by the state and by the private sector. And then finally, non-representational theory and approaches, which considers the happening of place, atmospheres, things like that, the immediacy of place. So we wanted to bring these all together, so a student wanting to do a master's or a PhD, whatever their theoretical orientation, could learn from the book and learn others. So yeah, it's a broad philosophical, conceptual scope, for sure. Mm-hmm.
Mark asked me to speak about the impact that we think this book will have going forward. By the way, I'm the token American on the editorial team. And I say that jokingly, but there's actually a sad truth to that, because geographical gerontology isn't as strong in the United States right now as it is in Canada and the rest of the world. And the reason is these two guys. They are actually world leaders in this field. And so they have really inspired and generated students that have carried the torch so far. But as far as the impact of this book, really this is the first book of its kind, like Mark suggested. It's a compendium that brings great breadth to the field together in one place for the first time, with a lot of depth also included, and authors from all over the world. So it will speak to scholars very broadly in a global sense. What we hope will happen as an outcome of this book, however, is it will inspire the next generation of geographers doing gerontology and give them not only the resources to go forward, but we talk about gaps in the book throughout, and there are a bunch of different theses that could come out of these gaps that are suggested. And hopefully geographers will continue to move forward and be leaders in this field. But I'm also a social gerontologist when I introduce myself to people. I'm not just a geographer, I'm a social gerontologist. And gerontologists, as I have argued previously, really have only scratched the surface in terms of their understanding of geography and what it brings to the study of aging. And so I'm hoping that my gerontological colleagues will learn a lot from this book. And the final outcome is hoping to get those two groups together. I think this book holds a lot of potential to generate more transdisciplinary work in this area. And that's where the game is these days, really not just to work within your own silo, but to get outside and work with other people. We have a lot to offer as geographers, but those gerontologists doing work over the decades have a lot to offer to these geographical perspectives as well.
So perhaps I'll just conclude with a couple of comments. One is, if you'd like any information, we have promotional flyers that our publisher in the UK kindly provided, reference to dollars and euros, so if you want that translated, you can help with that. The other thing to comment on in terms of, just to thank Malcolm and Gavin for what's been one of the most enjoyable academic experiences that I've had, and you guys may not be aware of this, but this started, as often things do amongst geographers, at a pub. And in this case, it was in East Lansing, Michigan. And what happened after maybe only half a beer, we'll just say, from being recorded. Are we being recorded?
Yes, we are.
Okay. So I think it was just a soda water, quite frankly. On the back of the receipt is the initial table of contents for this book, which Gavin and I sort of brainstormed in one of, you know, our enjoyable partnerships together. So I took the liberty of making copies as bookmarks for my two great friends here. And mainly just, I suppose sometimes it's useful for other people to understand how much, well, one, there's a lot of fun, that's not always related to the pub, but that certainly helps. But that's, you know, one of the things about working within geography, and especially health geography, which is the field that links all of us together, is a really long-standing mindfulness within that discipline to provide opportunities for people to build sort of relationships across different generations of academics. And so this is actually the product of that. So I just wanted to sort of publicly acknowledge that. You can't see on the screen, but you can look closely at the receipt if you want to see what kind of afternoon we have.
I saw the Neil Hanlon.
Well, yes, yeah, so one of our authors, Neil Hanlon, is actually the person who paid for the receipt. He actually,